And everybody had boots back then, so you're gonna clean your boots on that before you get all the shit off your boots. So.
Side blades were made by heating a piece of crucible steel between layers of wrought iron, then hammering the sandwich together. This forge welding process required the huge power of tilt hammers, which drew their energy directly from the water wheels. Once the structure of the scythes had been laid down, they were passed to the grinders, who ground sharp edges on the blades. The grinder sat astride a wooden coursing and pressed the blade into a spinning grindstone. The leather driving belt was turned by a line shaft from the water wheel. The finished scythes were painted with blacking to prevent rust. They were wrapped in straw rope and stored in the warehouse. The blades were usually sold without handles because they were cheaper to ship. Abbeydale scythes were sold around the world. For centuries, production moved to a modern factory in the city, powered by steam and electricity. When the works closed,